In this video, we will show you how to dry a sample using sodium sulfate. So we have two samples here. In the first, we have slightly less water, so you'll see how that affects the sample. We will unscrew the sodium sulfate. You should always leave the cap on when not in use. Uncap your sample and add one scoop of sodium sulfate. If your sample does not have much water in it, you should see that the little individual crystals of sodium sulfate are free-floating. That means you are done drying your sample. In the second sample, it contains a bit more water, so we will need a little more sodium sulfate. Uncap your sample and start by adding one scoop of sodium sulfate. If you look underneath your Erlenmeyer flask, you see that all of the sodium sulfate has clumped in one spot. That means we need to add another scoop. We add another scoop, look at it again, and see that it is still clumpy. So we can continue by adding another scoop of sodium sulfate. Swirl. Look under your flask, and you see that now you are starting to have a few free-floating pieces of sodium sulfate. That means you are finished drying. When you have finished, you can recap the bottle to make sure that it stays anhydrous.